Let's go ahead and talk about the legacy. That's right, of the Superman Lover. As you know, he's always dropped a Superman Lover track on all albums, or most albums. Is it safe to say on almost all albums?
I think all.
I'm gonna go ahead and say let's just say
the last one was like maybe like a small little skit. I think
he's kept the Superman Lover mantra and character alive, obviously throughout all these years. So it's only right, like I said, that we help dissect the introduction and then also like where he was by album number three. So let's go ahead and play the Superman Lover tracks off each album. A Day of Superman Lover off of what the album? Class.
Go up in the sky.
It's the boy.
It's the man.
No, it's Superman Lover, baby.
Pause. Pause.
I was out for lunch and shit, puffing on a blunt to get my hat back. Moving into my wrong man with the S on my chest. Yes, I'm a sipping herbal, don't forget. I smoke bad niggas, fucking down with the cigarette. But anyway, let's get back to the skit. You know who the fuck I am, so get off that old bullshit. Sun Towers up. Fuck, let me jet or I'll collect unemployment bucks on the way back.
Ooh, listen, I want to hear that whole thing right now.
Very tough.
It's like I said, if you're a fan of Redman, you know that he continued the series for many a long time and many other products down the line. So much so that he did it again on his second release, Dares of Dark Side. But tonight, we're talking about the third release. So we talk of Superman Lover Part 3. Y'all might recognize this. Y'all might recognize the sample. Another brother from Queens may have used it at one point in time.
Up in the sky.
It's
a plane.
Nah, motherfucker.
I was flying through the motherfucking sky with my blunt full of lies. My YZ05, full name, he's the super. Man, pop my Luga, blast the stage. I'm on the run, G. I got these hoes spread from Japanese to diabetics. So stay painted because of my foot fetish. You damn right, they had to ban me from eating pussy all night. WWF bitches slamming them in a rope like Shawn Mike. I can't be touched, bitch. I disco with kryptonite. Shit, I'm broke as hell. I had to buy all my girls 5411 Reeboks at wholesale.
5411s, if you knew, you knew.
That's second. That's like that crooning music, kid. You got your yak in your hand. You know, go to the piano bar.
What a gentleman!
As they play the Red Man in the background.
Listen, man. Again, two classic tracks.
You drink like this, right, Breeze?
Yeah. You put it to your nose, like
sniff it, roll it around,
roll it around a bit.
Word.
Yeah, smell. You guys smell the notes. Listen, a classic track.
Make a 45.
Yeah, you know, classic track, same classic theme. We're talking Red Man. We're talking the legacy of Superman Lover. We have to put them up against each other. It's only right. Was he better when he started? Was he better as he advanced? Listen, Superman Lover, round number two. Who do you got?
I'm going to go with the third installment. I feel like he was just finding his way with the first one.
And yeah.
We're not talking about the second one. Third one, man, that one, he was in his pocket with that one, man. He got busy with that one.
It hit different. Yes, it did. It
definitely hit different, bro. And like you said, you know what? I'm gonna give some credit to my man Breeze here. I really like the
content
of holding the sifter and taking that yak while you listen to Redman spit bars.
I can see the two of you easily at a French cafe in Paris, just cigars and wine. I wait for croissants to show up. I can see it. I can see it in my
yes.
Okay, fair enough. So Hobo placing the first vote down for the round number for the Superman Lover number three. Is anybody else feeling the same? Anybody else feeling different? What's going on? Who do you got? YZ.
Yeah, I mean, I'm on the OG regular original shit just because the second one was more Ghostface-y for me, and that's cool. But the first one was a little bit easier to listen to. It was kind of original Red Man. Throws back more memories for me in high school and stuff like that.
Uh-huh.
So I gotta go with you. And I'm a what fanboy by default. So
by default. Scan, yeah. I'm gonna go to you next, but the question was related to YZ's point. Who is the sample for both? Is the first one Sly and the Family Stone, or am I bugging?
Watson on the first one, and I believe the second one is the Heath Brothers Smiling Billy Sweet, something like that. It's escaping me, but I believe that's in the chat. Can help me out if I got it wrong.
Superman Lover 3 was Red and Sermon.
I think so.
This was 3 right here. This was Superman Lover 3.
Yeah, that was a Red and Eric track, I believe.
Mm. Is Eric Sermon on that track? I don't.
Well, no, production, I'm saying. Production.
Oh, probably. I mean, well, you know, it's funny.
I thought you meant production.
No, no, but it's funny why he brings that up, because I wanted to talk about it at some point as well. Matter of fact, I'm going to wait for that segment. But let's definitely talk production at some point.
Dreddy underscore SRS said he's going with here. Or she is going with Johnny Guitar Watson on this one, so that's the first one.
Yeah.
Johnny Guitar Watson, damn. Okay, yeah. Damn, no, it's a good one. Again, it's a classic sound, introduces the character. Funny as hell. Like I said, but that third album, like I said, you know, I think someone y'all mentioned, there's a little more maturity involved right there, a little bit more laid-backness. I mean, which is it the angry no-stuffer, or is it the more laid-back, you know, cigar puffer, yak in the hand?
It's honestly all of it, but for this round, I'll take the Superman Lover 3 just because I think for anybody listening to the album, it was great and amazing the first time. And you always were like, where's he going to be able to take it? The second one was dope. You know what I mean? And then the third one came around. He was like, where's he going to be able to take it? And it fucking stands on its own. You know what I'm saying? So. Yep.
Agreed.
I think he learned from his mentors, right? APMD with the Jane record, they kind of took that on as well. Then this character kept making it live. But I want to go to a cool Breeze for a second. Breeze, I know you saw what was going on right there. When I just answered, I peeped another habit. You had both of them kind of I saw it's kind of both of them. It's World Cup. So it's yellow flag to Ike. Yellow flag, relax. Ooh. Yellow flag. Yellow flag.
Oh, football. You know what I'm saying? Yo,
what Breeze has made an effort to knock both of us to death for the last few weeks. And you habitually line stepping. Habitually.
In soccer, we're not allowed to chest bump the ref, right? Because that's the red card, so I can't.
Listen, man. I'll mute you right now, man. Listen.
Why are you coming for Ike today?
Cool breeze. I saw the habitual line. I saw the constant teasing with the boat. Yeah, get off camera for a second. Habitual line step. Breeze, we all know you the inventor of the both of them. We know that. Yes, and we know you continuously made an effort, thank you, by the way, to not constantly both of us to death, if that makes any sense.
Okay.
So again, you take your time now, brother. Who do you got, bro?
Well, you see, Mr. Jules, I licensed the both of them to Ike for the both.
I didn't get the memo. You gotta tell me. I'm over here chewing them up. You gotta tell me.
We have a license.
Thank you, Breeze. Agreement. Thank you, Breeze. I appreciate that.
I apologize. I'm just trying to stay. I'll stand up just as hard for you if someone else here was trying to dress like Tupac. I would shut it down.
I appreciate it, man. But you know, I gave me a couple of coins to for the licensing agreement.
The both of them franchise.
Yes, working on it, franchising it. Yes, it'll be see one down in Virginia too. Yes, yeah, so the third installment, because that one, you know, it seemed like Superman Lover flew over to Paris.
I get a Paris vibe from it. Does he mention the word Paris, or am I bugging?
Yeah, you know, he had on his suit and he was at the cafe with his drink looking for his date. That's the type of vibe I got from it. So I'm going to go with number three. All of them are cool, but this one, it hit a little differently. Just a little different.
Listen, and I think Redman prefers the third one too. I never see him or hear him perform the first joint.
That's a good point.
What about
Meth and Red versus? Yeah. I knew he did three. He didn't do one.
He performed the third one in the verses. Yeah.
Did he? Absolutely. With the cape. Remember they were
with the cape. Yeah.
That's
right. And he said, he's like, yo, I don't have too many ladies' joints, but this is my ladies' joint right here.
Yeah.
That's the ladies' joint.
Redman is the fucking illest, man. He's the fucking illest, bro.
Yeah. Put on the shit for ladies. Like, oh,
one of us puts that on and we have a lady that's a fucking ghost.
We've all seen Redman's crib, so it's like, you know, whatever. Like, at this point,
that one's it. When you listen to that third one, it's like a James Bond type of joint, man.
Some golden eye shit. Like, you walking around like, hey.
He painted a story in that one with the beat, man.
I mean, I have a question for the producers on the third one. Is he just, respectfully, early ghost facing? Is that just the instrumental playing for the original record? Or is that like looped at some point?
No, it's looped.
It is? That shit sounds like it goes into like the rest of the record at some point.
It does, but the whole record is longer than that. He used probably, let's say, for conversation sake, let's say he used what, 12 bars of it, of the original song.
To YZ's point, if I put on the Superman Lover and she bounces, and probably she's not the one if she stays.
Wow.
Stays.
I'm still nervous about the girls that stay over while Redman's playing. Yeah, and knowing word for word. No offense. I'm just saying, I said word for word. If you like Redman, you like, but if you know the words to album songs, like what we call the album fillers, respectfully, more than me, like I'm just looking at you like a whole different kind of, like, oh, she's special, and I don't mean that in a good
respect. You like she's one of the hood rats in the hood rats kit? That's yeah. What you're saying?
Oh, no, those don't even make it here. We never met. So respectfully, like, it looks like there's a good side of the room going with volume number three. Why is he being the first to move on, I'll say volume number one, the version number one. Is anybody else feeling the same? So we want to wrap up this round. Does anybody want to go with what's the album? Everybody's going, okay, so Trip and Scan both going for number three, Superman Lover 3, I mean. Wrapping up round number two, we decided to talk about the Superman Lover's legacy, version number one versus version number three. Again, we're talking what the album versus Muddy Waters. And it looks like the majority of the room decided to go with the Muddy Waters Superman Lover number three for the winner of this round. So round number two officially puts Muddy Waters up on the board. It's officially tied up 1-1, Eat Beats and Rhymes. We do this every Monday night, man, live, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on Twitch. Don't forget, we have episodes dropping every week. New episodes, YouTube, like, subscribe, comment. Shout out to everybody that comments. Shout out to everybody that likes. And I love seeing the dislikes. I know it sounds corny, but I love it. This means that you're
perfect. Shout out to Nerd Chris, man. Shout out to Nerd Chris.
I love that.
Nerd Chris, shout out to Nerd Chris. Yes. Shout out to everybody in the chat room. Matter of fact, I'm so sorry. Hobo, do you mind just sort of getting the opinion on the chat room on what they thought about the Superman Love and Legacy? What were they thinking? Can we maybe do we are affiliates now. Can we get a poll going? Is that any kind of way we can make that happen? Pause. For those who don't know what I'm talking about. If we can, it's all right. We can still do it old school style. Yes. Let me know what you think in the chat room. Superman Lover 1 versus Superman Lover 3. Let us know what you think. Man, it's exciting times. We're on podcast areas. We're on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, iHeart Music. Check us out. Like, subscribe. Let us know what you think. And keep following us.
Yep.